I say, okay, I like the music. Now, let me go and watch all the shows. I see all the shows, how he performs. I say, good. I watch all these interviews.
You said there's not one interview you haven't watched.
Not one.
No, he said he hasn't missed one.
All of them. I was listening to this guy, his noisy documentary, everything. Mm. I say, okay. Skepta, say, start small. Go to where they don't know you. Everything he did. That's what we're doing now.
Yes, Link Up TV family, we are back once again for an episode of The Control Room. Myself, Chris DeCapo, and I'm joined alongside my brother, my guy.
You already know what's going on, man. It's your boy, Kamzu SCP, the Afrobeat connoisseur. And I'm here, man, stepping in for MAM. Follow me back, man, please. But I'm here, but outside The Control Room, man. You know what's going on.
Yes, and we have got a very, very special guest that's in the building right now. Listen, right now, we are going straight towards Niger. We are going right to the capital.
You know what's going on.
We are going to the, I would say, not even arguably, the freshest act right now in Nigeria.
I can accept that.
Who's definitely a breath of fresh air right now. This is my guy, Igwe. Odumodu Black is in the building.
Boy.
Black sheep alive. Black sheep alive.
I'm trying to say black. Guys, get me over the black.
Black sheep forever. My team of gangs are deep. Black. Listen, we got Odumodu Black, aka Big Kala, Big Gun, William Pomba, Vladimirich.
It's going.
You know, you actually look like a Vladimirich.
Yeah.
Like, when I think of that name, I think of a serious, like...
This is a serious guy.
Serious guy.
Why didn't you bring the hat today?
I was even going to ask to wear it.
Yeah, I was going from here to there, you know, and I don't want people to spot me on the street.
Fair.
It's my guy. For those who aren't familiar and are living clearly under a rock, tell them who is Odumodu Black and why should they know who you are?
Yeah, I'm the truth. You know,
is your cool.
I'm what the game didn't have for a long time. Mm. You know, it's been 13 years since a hip hop album organically went top of the charts with hip hop. We didn't call any Afrobeat guy to come and sing our hooks.
Yeah,
ask Teezy, we did it ourselves on their own turf. That's what Blood on the Dance Floor is. Mm. For that reason, because I'm the guy, they should know, everybody that has not bought their stock should go and get their stock now, because like it's happening. No matter how much they try to deny it, you know, even if they don't want to bow with their knees, in their soul they can feel it that we're here.
It's my guy, you know,
big man thing.
Do you know what I like more than anything is the first and foremost is the fact that you being from Abuja, we haven't had that in ages. Can't even recall who was the last Abuja artist.
Is there anyone that we're forgetting that's come from Abuja?
That's why I'm the guy. Everything was stacked against me.
Mm.
Hip hop, Abuja, rapping in native lingo, pidgin English. The swag is not pop swag, it's real swag, Tupac swag.
Mm.
You know, everything they said would not work. I did it and we got away with it.
Mm-hmm.
And we're there now, standing in the test of time. We didn't even really care if they didn't believe in the vision, because that's normal.
Mm.
You know, because before you guys started this P, I'm sure there were some people that were saying, this P is not going to work, but see, we're here.
Mm.
You know? So, like, a lot of people are coming from Abuja. I'm not the only guy. You know? I'm not even the one with the best music out of there.
Mm.
But heavy is the head that wears the crown. I was the one that was chosen to lead them to the promised land. I said in Dog Eat Dog.
Mm.
You know? And because of the kind of person I am, I'm very selfless. I'm representing the whole community, and there will be more people that are going to come on this platform, you know, because I've come here. Maybe if there was someone else that came here before me, I would not have gotten this opportunity. That's why God puts me here before them.
Mm.
You know, big man thing.
100%. Even going as far as saying the sense of with that core Nigerian hip hop sound. Mm-hmm. When I think about that, I think of the early, early days.
Mm.
I think of, who was it, my man, who made How to Survive? It was from Lagos to London, and he had a mixtape from back. This is early Ben days.
I can't think.
That this is early 2003, 2004. No, but it's around the same time as like JJC crew.
LD guys, all those guys.
Those type of guys who came originally. But they were doing it more with, like, no disrespect to them, but with that American twang accent. With yours, it's just strictly just Igbo, and also just sounding like the Mandem as well. Like literally one of us, you would say. Do you feel like this, the odds have been stacked against you to some extent? Because when you look at the Nigerian scene as a whole, it's predominantly very Yoruba dominated,
yeah,
if you want to say so.
Yeah.
And then you being Igbo as well, like, do you feel like the odds have been stacked against you in that sense?
Yeah, definitely. Because like most of the guys that are up there, mm-hmm, like the guy that you meet to link you up with the guy, see, Tizzy is a Yoruba guy now.
We got Tizzy in the building.
You get me? And he can't even testify. Before he got to where he was, there were some guys that were like, ah, this guy's doing rubbish. Now he wants to open a label. Let's see what's going to happen. Mm. You know, but I was lucky to be born in Lagos. Mm. I'm Igbo. Yeah. I was lucky to be born in Lagos, which is a Yoruba state. Mm. Then I moved to Abuja, which is a Hausa state, a northern state. And Nigeria is Igbo, Hausa, Yoruba. Mm-hmm. So like I have everyone's culture in me. Mm. So the guys in ABJ in Abuja, when I went there, they could not handle my chakra. Do you know the meaning of chakra? Mm. Mm. My energy, you know? Like, ah, why is this guy? This guy is moving faster than us. Mm. Everything that happened in Abuja, like last year, I told them was going to happen 3 years ago because I was born in Lagos. Mm. In Lagos, 5 o'clock is 5 o'clock. If you miss it, it's done. It's just like London, you know? But Abuja is a bit relaxed. Everybody's chill. They're at home and enjoying. So I took that energy there and put it in the music industry. And it was too much for them. They're like, ah, let's just let him explode. We don't want his problem, I beg.
Even down to speaking about the project, Izioku.
Yeah.
The truth.
Let's get a round of applause for that project. Because like you said, you listen to the project and it's like, this guy's special. Bruv, like it's not every
it's
single song.
Cold. Like, it's cold. Know,
there's a key thing you said there, and it was like you didn't need no one singing your hooks.
Yeah.
Because you can do it yourself.
Yeah.
But you're also a bad man rapper in the process. It's not a joke. So for me, growing up, I've been listening to Yoruba music, Nigerian music, Afrobeat my whole life. My dad was a DJ. Mm. So the first Nigerian rapper I ever heard properly was probably Idris Abdul Karim. Mm. That was someone that I said, okay, this guy is cold.
Yeah.
Speaking about everything. And then after him, I didn't really hear a lot. But there's someone that you said is a very important person. You said someone that's the best. You said MI.
Yeah.
I've seen some of you said MI is the MI. Best. For me, I didn't really see a lot of MI. Maybe that's because I'm from the UK.
Yeah.
But for me, since Idris Abdul Karim and then you, I don't think anyone in that gap has kind of done anything with a core hip hop kind of sound, authentic, not mixing sound, not mixing, you know, the kind of groovy kind, just straight raw rap.
Yeah.
What do you think about that statement? Do you feel like there's people are missing out, or do you feel like it makes sense?
I think people did pure rap, but they didn't make it exciting for people to gravitate towards it. You know, how can you be in Oju Elegba and you're rapping like, yeah, I want to get some burger. Da, 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 da. Mm-hmm. Nobody's going to understand what you're saying. Mm. I went to school. People are on Twitter. They're like, they love the album, but you know, people are going to be critics and they'll be like, ah, but the rap is kind of sounding like a, like nursery school rhyme. Mm-hmm. Like I dumbed it down so I could sell this record. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to think twice. When you listen to my rap, if you understand the lingo, you get it once. You don't have to go to any dictionary. Mm. It's not information for the nation, combination. No. it's easy. It's easy. I've made it exciting.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, the way Wizkid can say 3 words 10 times and you just like it. You know? So I've tried to bring out that Nigerian hip hop and make it sound so authentic. You know, and make it sound sweet and exciting. You want to gravitate towards when you enter your car. That's what you want to listen to. You know, it's more than just rapping. I can rap like Eminem and all these guys, but bro, where I come from, nobody's gonna listen to that stuff. They don't understand it. You know,
it's funny you're saying that because I feel like right now I'm getting the flows. So you feel like there's another level you can take it to?
Yeah, definitely. Like,
I've
been doing it.
My guy.
I've been doing
my
it.
Guy.
I have records where they are not even out. They are proper rap records. Yes. But like, you need to take the people along.
Of course.
You know, that's what makes you an artist. That's what makes people gravitate towards you. You can't just be a narcissist and say, yo, this is my stuff. This is what I make. It's done. Anybody that doesn't like it, go and sit down. You know, go see Food Chop. But we've made it, we've stuck to it. We're not even bending for anybody. This speed that I'm doing, I created it. I made it like this so people would enjoy it. Mm. I want them to enjoy rap music again. Mm. I want rappers to, I want girls to rap my stuff and be like, oh my God, it's so nice. It's sexy, it's sweet. Mm. It's exciting, you know?
Speak to us as well, because listening to the project, there's the UK drill influence,
mm-hmm.
and it's that UK rap influence, even down towards the flows and the patterns of it, specifically on songs like MC Oluwomo, and also even on Hammer Time as well, modern type of tunes where it just sounds like, bruv, I could hear one of the Mandem on this. Like, it is literally the Mandem. Like, speak to us on, you know, the influence UK drill, UK rap has had in your music, musical journey.
You know, most of the, unlike America, most of the black rappers in UK are connected to their roots.
Of course.
You see Unknown T, Uganda.
Yeah.
You see Hoss.
Yeah.
You see Pasalu.
Mm-hmm.
You see Skept.
Yeah, we
put him there for you because you know that's your guy.
That's your guy.
That's the Don.
Yeah.
You know.
Speak to us about that relationship as well.
I've heard a lot. That's you get me. Proper guy.
Ah no, that's the Don. You know, like. I didn't even. Let's. We'll talk about Skept. <anyway.
laughs> that's his own side of it. Yeah.
So like, I relate with these guys more. You know, when you, as an African rapper, when you listen to J-Hus and you listen to, let's say, Ludacris, you connect more to J-Hus.
Of course.
It's more interesting. It's exciting. This guy is saying things that we don't even understand in his native language, but it just sounds powerful. You know, that's the kind of shit I want to navigate to, navigate towards, you know? Yeah.
So why on the project, the only thing I thought that was not necessarily missing, as if we should have had it, but I thought you would have had a UK feature on the project.
Like we saw with the Unknown T, Welcome
to
Nigeria.
Yeah. What about that? What do you think? Anything personal or just it just didn't happen?
Now everybody in on that project is my friend.
Mm.
You know, nothing was forced. You know, I don't want to meet anybody and come off like I'm begging you to do stuff when I know who I am. It's not even pride. You know, it's just respect. Because, like, I might really need you on my tune, but you might not want to be on it. I don't want to bug nobody. Let everybody, like, everybody that is on the tape is out. They are pushing it where they are. They are happy to be on it.
True.
I don't want to go and Central C is my friend. But I cannot be sending him song to record. And I don't know whether he wants to do it or whether he has a project. So let us sit down. Let himself be gingered. Say, Odi, let's do something. So when it comes out, I don't need to be telling Sench, oh, post this, post that. No.
That you want to do it.
Yeah, you know.
Makes sense.
Mm. Yeah.
Let's talk even a role as well with the influence even more. Let's talk even creatively because of Sloan obviously doing the artwork.
That's my
for
boy.
As well. What was it you wanted this whole project to envision? Like, what did you want people to grasp from this? As in, not only sonically, but you as a person.
Basically, realness. You know, realness. Everybody from my hood, I want them to be comfortable to pass the message with what they are, in a way they know how to, not in how they told them to. You get what I'm saying? Okay, now, for instance, I'm in America, and my cousin's name is Adefiola. He's Yoruba. And a white person asks him, what's your name? He said, Fiola. I'm looking at him. I say, okay. Second day he did it. I say, bro, don't try that shit again. The name is Fiola. If they don't know how to pronounce it, tell them. You can pronounce John. You can pronounce Whitaker. You know, you can pronounce Ronaldo.
Blasikowski.
Vladimirovich. So make them know who you are.
That's true.
Be comfortable with it. You know, that's why I love my name, Odumodu. If I meet 100 white people in London, I can guarantee you that 90 have not heard that name. And for them to hear about it, I'm like, this is new. And the guy is now coming out with good music, proper swag, the proper team, record label, everything bussing. Like, they'll be invested in it. I think we should go and look for another Odumodu. And now they will now come to now enter my hood. When they now they are looking for Odumodu, they will now go there and see someone that's trying to sound like Central C. No, that's not it. I want my guys to be
authentic.
To be authentic, to be confident. That's what the tape is about. It's the truth. We are here now. There are so many people that make the kind of music I make, but they just don't have the opportunity. I'm here for them to show them that it's possible. Do it. Yeah, that's what the tape is about.
What made you even think there was time of, obviously, and big congratulations of doing the joint venture with Native Records and with 027 Def Jam? Yeah. What made you realize that, okay, this is the right time, rather than, you know, as the majority of people may do, is go to indie or, you know, keep going themselves? What made you go specifically with them?
A lot of people in Android that I see as well, because I saw that at one point it was you and one PRM. A lot of them take the distribution route, but now obviously you've gone with the label route and then now you're with Def Jam. Talk to us about that.
Like Bonaboy said, depending on where you are coming from, your masters are relative. I know where I'm coming from. 30% of something can be more than 100% of another. Of nothing. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, I've gotten to this stage where I've done everything myself. I've sharpened my armor, I've cleaned my bullet, I've cleaned my gun, everything, my shield. I've entered inside my armor tank. Now I just need direction to point me to where the war is happening. That's what the record label does. A lot of indie guys, you say, yo, I'm indie, I'm this. You are bragging about being indie. What's there to brag about when Beyonce is under a label? Kendrick is under a label. Fela was under a label. Bob Marley. You can't do it yourself. Even our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, when he came, he took 12 people with him. And that's God. He took people with him. But you say you want to do it on your own. How far can you go? Okay. Because you don't want somebody to take a little bit, take for a gain from you or milk.
That's even greed.
You want everything to yourself. You want to produce your song. You want to mix and master it. You want only you. You know, that's why I don't even want to learn how to produce records.
Yeah.
Because there are some people that were born to do it. And they are my friends. I say, yo, if I start producing my records, you're not going to eat. So I'll let you do it. Do it. Let's move together as a unit. We'll meet a label that will take us to the biggest level. If indie label, they very, very good. Beyonce with all her money.
Why?
She would have left.
Of course.
See my sister here. Everywhere I am, she's always there for me. There's another white guy, that Johnny. He's ride bicycle everywhere we're going to. If I was indie, will I have that? You know, if Jesus, who is God, came down and took other people, he could have done it on his own now.
It's true. I understand.
If Jesus did not do it on his own, who am I? So you need people to amplify your talent as an artist. Indie, good for a period of time to understand who you are. You know, so you're not going to sign the deal that because you're hungry. Then when you meet people that align with your vision, you move with them and move on to the next level. So all of you that are indie and you're forming Superman, I'll find people that amplify your talent too.
How was it like of getting the label to actually see a vision of who Odumodu Black is anyway?
Yeah, like Native Records, I've been telling them since like 2019 when there was no label. You know, shout out my man Davido, love him so much, real guy. You know, but in 2019 someone was like, yo, let's go to Lagos, let's go and meet Davido. I said, what would Davido do for me? Even if Davido takes me to America, puts me on tour and I'm rapping my stuff, like, his fans won't understand because those are Afrobeat fans. But these guys, them TZ, Chubbs, Budge, these guys are the pipeline to the UK market. And those are the closest guys I sound like internationally. So why don't I follow that route to get to wherever I want to get to? You know? And I was like, I don't need Davido for anything now. Let me follow people that align with my vision. And that's how we just came together. And we're here now, number one in the country. Against all odds. Tell them they have to respect that thing. Because we're coming from... We went for an awards and we didn't even have seats, me and TZ. They don't respect hip-hop in Nigeria. They don't respect us. But with us in the game now, they respect us. There, check it. Buju is number two. He's blown more than me. He has more fans, more listeners. But we're number one because the streets has gravitated to the music. He's now more than me and TZ. He's no more about us again.
Always. I've always seen that in Nigeria. It's very important. They care a lot. That's why you see a lot of the biggest artists, people that they love Olamide for the streets. Even Naira Marley, they love. Like, these are people that they love. You know what I'm trying to say? So it's good.
So that's what we're on.
So the project now is it cool? What do you think is your favorite song on that project so far? I have mine. I'll say mine first.
What's yours?
My doggy dog. I can't.
All day.
You made the song. You made the song. Now added Bella Shmurda on that song. I said, yay. I said, listen, you're doing some things. Bella Shmurda is a special guy. He's special. And he's a selfless guy as well. I like him from the beginning when I started listening to him. So when you added him on top, I said, yeah, this song is, I can't stop listening to it. It's still my favorite song.
Evergreen.
Chris, what about you?
I have two. I'm not going to lie to you. So Commend. The way it kicks off.
Intro. That's what you call an intro.
I can't lie. I was listening to it on the way here and then I just wheeled it up again and I was like, yeah.
Yeah.
I said, yeah, let's get this popping. Then after, because me, I'm a rap guy. So MC Oluomo, when I heard that, I said, this is my rhythm as well. So this is my
That
rhythm.
Track cost probably in Nigeria.
Why? How? Talk about that.
Okay, so like, MC Oluomo is like one of the president's boy. He works for the president. He works for our president, Tinubu. He has been his guy from day one, organizing stuff for him, you know. But when it comes to politics, whether you're on the good side, people say it's bad side, whatever side, you just feel it's a dirty game, you know. And MC Oluomo is seen like as the king of the streets in Lagos. He makes everything work, if you understand what I'm saying, king of boys. And I remember making that song on the day after Messi won the World Cup, because I'm a huge Messi fan.
Because you make a reference to it as
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
You
should have
and
said
I'm,
that before you came on the table.
You get me? And I made that song for Messi. Like, in the song, you know how artists are now. Declan Rice is not about Declan Rice. You know, I was like, man, this Messi guy, he has the spirit of MC Oluomo in him. He's a, we're not going to lose. At all, we'll share the spoils. You know? And that's what the song was about. The song came out, like I had a snippet of it. Everybody were happy. Ah, nice, nice, nice. But when the song was dropping, I was like, how am I going to brand this song? MC Oluomo is known for causing chaos. Okay, let me cause chaos. And I tweeted, where's the MC Oluomo and you? Everybody went mental. I'm like, yep, that's what I want. And the streams kept on going. And people are like, what's wrong with this record? Let me even go and listen to it. What's happening? Blah, 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 blah. But at the end of the day, it's a slapper. People still love it because I did it with a genuine heart. I'm not out here hailing anybody's misdeeds or mischievous pee. You know, but in my country, normally, even everywhere, people are hypocrites. People are outside singing, I think I'm Big Mitch. People will be in clubs shouting, Larry Hoover. But now you have a problem with MC Oluomo. Doesn't make no sense.
At all. But your favorite song, what's yours personally that hits home the best?
Right now it's Commend.
You know, that's the way you start a project.
Right, it is my will. I'm Miss Gigolo. Come on, bro.
That's my guy.
A feature I want to talk about on that project. So one of our guys, Wale. I always have to shout out Wale because the only person that wasn't afraid From the beginning to embrace his culture. You know, people only now people are saying, oh, I'm Nigerian. I've done my DNA test before. But we didn't know you were Nigerian before. So Wale, top guy, always respected him, always loved him. Talk to us. How did that feature come about?
I think he came to Lagos. TZ brought him to the house. I played him some records. It's like, yo, I could see it was like, yo, this guy's on something. You know, it's no hype. This guy's on something. Because I played him various records, pop, R&B, Afrobeats, grime, drill, hip hop. Like, yo, and next thing we sent him the record, dropped his first. You know, humble guy. When we were in America, hosted us. He wasn't even acting like he was so big. You know, like guys like that. When the tape was out, when the tape came out, song came out, posted it up. Rick Ross even posted it. You know. That's my guy. Those are the kind of collaborations I need. People that will go the extra mile for the. And the song is number one.
I think this is the best song.
This is Wale's first number one in Nigeria.
Wow.
Yeah. A bit easy. Now Wale's first number one be this bar. For Nigeria. Yes, son. Yeah.
Serious. How does it feel then? Like, would you say you're used to it now because you feel like you deserve it, or is it still surreal being around people like what? Because Wale is a legend over like what, since 09 with Lady Gaga, and he just continues to make music. Yeah. MMG, he's been doing his thing for a long time. Is it surreal to you, or is it just like, you know what, I deserve this?
Yeah, at first it's surreal, you know. You always have to, you know how God used to do his P now. He always do things that you've not seen or heard about, and you're like, oh my God, this is crazy. Then you're not adjusting to it. You know, it depends on the kind of person you are. Is it that you mess it up because you are too proud, or you embrace it and you embrace gratitude because you are humble? You understand? So I had to take the other route. Like, this is crazy. Like, this is all God. Because like, this is Maybach Music Wale, bro. Don't play.
No small Wale.
You know, not small Wale. That's see where I'm coming from. Where I'm coming from in Abuja, when we used to hustle for $1 to make records. You know, I can have like $4 and the session is $5. I have to go and borrow. Now I'm on the record with Wale. That's a blessing, you know. So and I don't take it for granted. It's not because I'm the best rapper or my music is so good. It's just grace, you know.
Even speaking of more big moments and blessings that you've had, Declan Rice, man.
Heavy.
I feel like that arguably might be one of the biggest, biggest hits.
It is.
This year.
Yeah.
And also was part of, you know, the best transfer reveal as well. Just saying. Let's speak about Declan Rice. Yeah. Most importantly, like, of you recording that. What made you even specifically go for that player? Because Declan Rice, yes, he's a big player, but he's not, as you mentioned, your Messi's, your Ronaldo's, or Harry anything Kane. Like that. Your Harry Kane,
Rashford.
You feel me? These anybody, these Were guys. Not any of these Were somebody guys. Like, what made you specifically go for Declan Rice and dedicate the song and use him as a metaphor for the tune as well?
Yeah. It's all God, you know, because like I didn't plan to do it. It was when I got into the studio, I'd wrapped up to that, like I'd done the hook up to that point, and I was like, quack them. And the next thing, because I said, men just buckle, like my guys are so plenty. It'd be like, then be right, I'm a football person. A lot of my songs, I use football references. The next thing I had to say, I did feel like Declan Rice, because he's a DM,
you know,
combatant, general, midfield, calculated.
Took that 100 million, 200.
100 big money Declan, 105 million. We got him for cheap.
Took that talk. Took heavy.
Took heavy.
We got him for cheap,
down.
You know. Yeah. You know, and like, and that's how the song came about. Mm. Will came into the studio, West Ham fan. First time I'm seeing him. Recorded it in Ghana, Slums guy Will. And connected me to West Ham fan page, to Declan. Declan is posting it up. The day the song drops, he scores for England. What are the odds? That it's the song is dropping, his scoring for England. If you had 100 people in the room to bet on who was going to score, I think Declan would have been next to the goalkeeper. After the goalkeeper, the next person to get the goal, the odds, like maybe Declan. You get me? And the next thing, he's winning Conference League first trophy for West Ham 53 years. Next thing, big money signing, record breaking. The next thing, we're smashing City, Community Shield.
Smash it, my guy. Just relax, smashing Man U in the league.
Smashing City again. Man is blessed.
How did it feel in the sense of where, even speak to us about the whole process of Arsenal reaching out to you when the transfer was done? Because again, we were all gassed off the transfer. Then when we heard Declan Rice, the actual tune, we said, Arsenal, you got it correct this time.
They had no other choice.
That was the song we wanted. That's the song we wanted for it. So yeah, speak to us about
it,
even
to say,
the process.
If to say they no use that song, they would have told them to just start again.
Of course, Riot. You have to get it right. Do it again. Yeah.
100%.
You know, so like they just reached out to someone that knows someone that knows someone, email back and forth, this, that. Got it done. They can't even know they were going to use it.
Wow.
I swear.
I'm telling you.
You done a dubplate one as well, to be fair. You done a special one for them.
Come on, man.
Serious.
It's a blessing.
It is. And it's not easy, because, not to throw any shade, but there's been so many, even in the UK, there's been so many artists that have, whether they were taking footballers' names and making it your own, or even making songs about footballers, and they haven't, nothing has happened. No,
it's real.
God is working.
Before I was born, God had already seen that day happen. That's how I see it, because I'm a firm believer. I'm a big believer in faith. That's what got me here.
Have there been any other footballers that have tried to holler at you saying, or Dumodu, come on,
please,
man.
Please, man, I need one more. You've got the
tune with Alex Iwobi as well, right? Yeah. Please, if any Arsenal player tries to ask you saying, let's get in the studio, we've got a Premier League title that we need.
Yeah, yeah.
Let it be after.
Saka wants one. Let him have it.
We'll do the Saka tune after.
This season, we're winning the Champions League.
Anyway, moving on. So I know you're big, so I've seen that if it wasn't music, apparently football would have been easily. Where do you play?
Oh, I play in my hood.
No, what position do you play?
Center back now. But I've stopped playing for now. I wish I had clips of my.
Find it.
It's heavy.
We need it.
Always bringing man down, you know.
Who would you compare yourself to?
Today?
No, that footballer wise, today.
Gattuso.
I'm picked certain legends. You just picked a legend, said,
Gattuso. What, you want to come and score that's my post? Then you run up scoring, celebrating.
How dare you,
man?
Nah, you did. Yeah, no, it's not possible.
Okay, I have another question for you. So this one is a personal one. Last year, an artist made a statement, they made a remark. So they came out and said, you know what? I'll be honest, I feel like Nigerian rap is dead. So Wizkid came about and said, I feel like Nigerian rap is dead, it's finished.
Yeah.
There was a lot of outrage behind it. You know, at that time, I hadn't necessarily heard of you. At that time, I felt like I agreed with the statement. Even though a lot of people were angry, you know, Rugged Man came out, you know, a lot of people spoke. How did that make you feel? Do you feel like you felt like Wizkid had a place to say that? Or do you feel like, you know, it was a bit on the ignorant side? Did it make you want to go harder? What came to your mind?
I was tremendously happy about the statement.
Oh, wow.
Because that's what the album is about, the truth. Hip-hop was dead. If Wizkid feels hip-hop was dead in his own right, then he's right. If someone else is he's not dead, that's the person's own. But me, I think it was dead. You could see hip-hop artists, they want to top the charts. They'll go and call Fireboy. They'll go and call Oxlade. They'll go and call Wizkid, say, please come and sing one hook for me. And now the song is not even about the rap bars. It's now about the hook. It's not about, rappers want to use these guys to sell records. You know? But since we came into the game, we've made it interesting.
You have.
You know, we've made them see that, you can do this P on your own. Like 50 Cent. Sing nice hooks. You know, that's what hip-hop is about, too. It's not just rapping. Make nice hookers. Thank you to the candy shop. I let you get, baby, your window shop. that guy is hard. Look at Unknown T. Fresh on, straight out of the slammer. I wasn't, you know, make it nice. Make it happy. Stop trying to sound like people in America. They are trying to sound like Kendrick Lamar. Kendrick Lamar, that's before he will rap, you first read the Bible from beginning to end. He will pray for one full day, then enter the studio and start rapping some Vortex stuff. Nobody's going to understand that in Nigeria.
Yeah.
£1 is 1,200 naira. Nobody wants to hear that. What they want to hear is, light that man with my pumpy. Tear gara not on the monkey. You know? Easy vibes, banter.
Can I be honest as well? I'll be real, this is a safe space, this is a control room.
Of course.
I feel like on Picanto, you brought that side back out of Zlatan.
Yeah.
I feel like that's what I haven't heard Zlatan, because Zlatan is a talented rapper. He's good, he can flow. You brought that back.
He came out guns blazing, booyaka, when you step out,
It's cold.
You know?
It's cold, I agree.
Yeah.
I agree.
It's the energy that was needed more than anything. We spoke about this earlier and we had to do a slight U-turn back to it.
I need to hear this.
The Skepta relationship.
What I've heard you say about this guy, I'm saying, is this your cousin?
This is
or
your
something?
Guy.
See, this morning.
This your guy.
This morning, Tizzy entered the room, was like, yo, Odi, we need to watch that Skepta documentary with Red Bull again, that interview.
Powerful. Very powerful.
The one where he said, you know, when you start, people are going to be like, what's he doing? Then later they'll be like, my man is hard, mm-hmm. you know? And that's how it has been from time. When I heard Skep, I knew that this was the guy. Mm-hmm. You know, during the time of Skep that they were, other guys rapping. I see Wiley, they respect. Mm-hmm. But as a Nigerian, I did not really understand Wiley. Mm-hmm. You know? But Skepta, he dumped it down. I picked myself up because I got self-made tattooed on my skin. Do you see that? Immediately you get it. Mm. I'm the one not to play the game if I'm not going to win. Mm. Sometimes I feel the perfect relationship is all in the bin. Like he's talking to a child. Mm. But it's so hard because it's so real. Mm. You can see the lyrics happen in your face. That's what he taught me.
That's a banger that you just quoted, by the way. Skepta, babe, if you don't know, yeah. Come on, this is me, you're my guy. Aye. Come on, you're my guy.
Aye.
That's banger as well, to be fair. Yeah.
Easy. Mm. I say, okay, I like the music. Now, let me go and watch all the shows. I see all the shows, how he performs. I say, good. I watch all these interviews.
You said there's not one interview you haven't watched.
Not one.
No, he said he hasn't missed one.
All of them. I was listening to this guy, his noisy documentary, everything. Mm. I say, okay. Skepta, I say, start small. Go to where they don't know you. Everything he did, that's what we're doing now. Mm. You know, and adding our own flavor to it. Because anything you learn, you add your own to try and make it better. Mm. And we hope that the guys coming after us would do the same thing. Like if my child, if my guy should give birth to his son now, like if you give birth to a child now, say, I pray that your child will be greater than you and I combined mm-hmm. together. Mm-hmm. That's the prayer. Mm-hmm. That the next generation will be way, way greater than us. And mm-hmm. everything we did that we did was huge. Imagine Wizkid's son coming out to come and sell that stadium. What stadium did he do?
Tottenham.
Yeah. Imagine his son coming out, one of his sons coming out to come and do the stadium 3 times, 3 days, back to back. Mm. To make Wizkid look very tiny, but that's the kind of prayer he'll be praying. Mm-hmm. You know? Mm. So you know that's Skep for you. Skep is the don. One day he tweeted, it was like he used to talk to the Modu spiritually and he'll just smile. Mm. This is Cheno. Mm. I didn't make it in Nigeria. He brought it out of his pocket and he gave me.
Wow.
Imagine Zlatan Ibrahimovic, who looks up to Ronaldo de Lima. The first day he sees Ronaldo de Lima, Ronaldo de Lima gives him a pair of boots and say, you take. Mm. I believe in your talent. Mm. Since that day, Chris, nobody could tell me anything. Mm. I knew that I was doing the right thing. Mm. You know, mm. regardless of what anybody says. Mm. And now we're here. I'm number one in Nigeria.
Number one, man.
Yeah.
Number one.
Let them respect the thing.
They know, man. What do you want to do? Black.
No, they know.
This is my guy.
I'm happy.
Before we do round up, what's the best way that you want to encapsulate everything right now of Odumodu Black's sound, character, person, and just where what your message is for the people?
I just think everything that's happening in Nigeria now, people need something to take their minds off of it, and that's where I come in. I bring that excitement. Oh my God, they're having a bad day. Let me just listen to Odumodu. Oh my God, I had a rough day at work. Let you enter your car. Let me listen to Odumodu. He's going to lift my spirit. And the only way you can do that genuinely is by creating a feeling with the music. Yeah. That's why you see some people, they can release a song today. It's up on the charts and it's falling. It's not like music is about the charts and numbers, but like it plays a great role. It shows you how the people feel. Like there's a guy called Charlie Poppy.
That's my guy. This year is you two for me.
You see that boy? There's a song coming with Charlie Poppy. It's heavy.
You and him.
Yeah, me and him. It's heavy. Christmas. It's gonna feel it.
I need to hear that one.
When you're in the club, you could play Wizkid, you could play Odumodu, you could play Burner. Everybody, nice, good. But when you hear Charlie Poppy, boom, man, no, there's a feeling. That's what I want my thing to do. Mm. Create that feeling. A safe place for people. Mm. And cause it's real, yeah.
Mm. But even just to quickly touch on like what you said, when I went to Shavaz came to the UK, he had like NSG, all these people. When Charlie Poppy came out,
the vibes.
Everyone, my phone dropped. Everyone, like, is, yeah. So it's, like I said, this 2023, you two for me. You two are the hottest things, and I'm enjoying every single thing I hear. So.
That's my brother.
Black, man.
Listen, we love to see the new wave of Nigeria coming through. Most importantly, man. Odumodu Black, thank you so much for coming into the control room.
Thank you so much.
Hey, Kamzo STP, my guy. Thank you once again for rolling through.
I'm here. How can Odumodu Black come here and I'm not here?
my guy.
M's in the back. I'm going to let her come out now.
Like, listen, big up for every single person that's been watching the control room. Please make sure you like, share, comment, subscribe. Big up my guy, Odumodu Black, every single time.
Bless, is your cool out now? Black Sheep Forever, Black Sheep for Life. You guys remember that one, Gansas G Records, Native, Brickity.
Trilo! Trilo!